Now we'll hear from Mr. Pierce, who's also running for Valdosta at large.
All righty, how are you all this afternoon? Well, first of all, I am not originally from the big gracious city of Valdosta as well. I'm originally from Atlanta. Atlanta Clark University in 1971, and I moved to Valdosta about 10 years ago, and I absolutely love it. I told my family when I die, don't transfer me back to Atlanta, just find me a hole in Sunset, and we can call it a day. I have never campaigned for any public office in my life. The only office I've ever campaigned for was the president of my high school student council, and I promise everybody who voted for me then that I will give you chocolate milk with your lunch. I can't give you chocolate milk. I can't make you promises. I realize that the power of any member of the city council, there are some limitations, and there's really not a lot that one city council person can do. But one thing, like the other candidates have said, that I think is important for Valdosta is a transportation system. Prior to coming here, I just attended a work session at the City Hall this afternoon for public transportation. I discovered that they came up with a budget for a 40-year plan. 40 years. We talk about 20, how many years is that? We talk about 2040, right? 2055 before the plan that we currently have will make any vision, will have any vision for public transportation. To me, that is not acceptable. We need transportation now. And I don't feel like we need transportation just in the city, in the confines of the city of Valdosta. It would take the other surrounding areas. And it would take the cooperation of the county as well. I understand that the county has turned down a request to give $6,000 in a pot for a transportation study. It's so important that the county and the city work together on this project because we're all in the same boat together, and we have to work together. We have to get to Howard and Lake Park and all the other surrounding cities and communities involved in it as well. If I'm elected, and I hope that I will seek ways to establish some sort of cooperation between the county and the city to establish some kind of transportation authority. The city council will probably consider this shortly a request for another transportation study because we have not had a transportation study in the last 5 years and the study that we have is currently outdated. I will also be a voice for expanding and keeping moving Air Force Base in Valdosta. That's an extremely important part of our economy. It's important that we support it, and all of the news articles that you've seen in the paper lately about changing the noise abatement plan, I think will actually hurt us instead of helping us. I would also like to see establishment of some sort of committee in the community to establish another city auditorium. This place is out here of this life. It's time for a place that we can attract larger conventions, we can have large events and concerts and so forth. One of the things that's extremely important to me, I think that when a person applies for a job for the city, one of the things that they ask for is that have you ever been convicted of a crime? I think that that's important. But at a certain point, after 6 or 8 years, that should not even be a factor. I mean, we have such high rates of unemployment in the city that if a person has not committed a crime or had a crime in 6 or 7 years, then that person should be at least considered for that job. We have a high rate of unemployment. We have a very high rate of unemployment in the city, and if we keep people who could work but they can't work because they did a crime 8 years ago, I mean, that just seems to be not fair. We all make mistakes, and we all should have a second chance. I will work closely with the Lowndes County Commission because I think it's important that we can establish some sort of committee to work on issues that affect us all. You know, Lowndes, maybe in Lowndes, Valdosta, maybe in the city, but we're all in the same boat. And we all need to go together to make this a success. Thank you very much, and I would anticipate and encourage you to vote for me in the election. Thank you very much.